Hi, welcome back to Studio Tamera, the Mystical Paintress. Today's Earth Day, and I would like to wish everyone a wonderful Earth Day amidst this Corona COVID virus. All the horrific things going on, there is some good. The satellite imaging above China shows the air pollution is cleared up, and I saw things on Facebook where elephants were being set free in Asia because the tourist groups weren't coming. There was even rumors about dolphins in Venice, but I think that was debunked. But definitely less driving, less emissions. The Earth is breathing better right now. So that's a little bit of light in the Corona darkness. I would like to send a shout out today because I think all jobs are really important. And I don't like it when people think that, a certain profession puts you above someone else. We are all equal and all jobs are important. And I'd like to send a shout out today to all of our zookeepers and all the people at the zoos and all the animal rescue sanctuaries who are feeding the animals and cleaning up the feces. And, that's a lot of work, like the big cats. But the De Young Zoo in the UP, the cat rescue, this shout out's for all of you. So thank you very much, you are appreciated. And I'm having my coffee and my little aperitif cup today, very fitting. My friend Bernadette asked about painting hands. We're not gonna paint hands today, but hands and faces, are just like, if you can paint a rock, you can paint a face, you can paint a hand. It's shapes and values. It's our mental block that has us thinking, oh, I can't paint that because, it's too hard. And no, really, it's not. You just paint what you see. So here is a hand I thought I'd share with you. And because it's Earth Day, it's kind of fitting. I don't know how many of you, when you were kids, remember the fairy tale that if you kiss a frog, you would meet a great prince. I don't know that I kissed any frogs, but I remember catching a lot of them, and I remember the story when I was a kid. So I saw a painting very similar to this online, and I just loved the idea. I wanted to paint it just for fun. So, the actual image is not my original idea, even though the hand's a little different and so forth, but just on an Earth Day, happy Earth Day. Kiss some frogs. It's the time of year the frogs are coming out, the toads are coming out. I have water by my house and I can hear the spring peepers at night, and it's just magical and wonderful and helps me sleep at night. So today what I would like to do is a tree. I would like for us to all get a blank canvas and we are going to block in a tree using burnt umber and black. This is my palette, my rainbow of colors. Isn't this great? Isn't this fun? This makes me happy, the colors. So I'm gonna set it right there. Can you see that okay? Super. And I wanna bring you in a little bit, but I noticed in some of my videos, like the back of my head's in the way. So for right now, we'll just paint from here, okay? And I kind of want to just do a very basic tree. I want to try and keep this video under an hour because they take forever to load up and I think you guys get bored. But okay, so if you're following along with our happy little trees, I'm going to get a Bob Ross wig. What do you think? Do a Bob Ross day with the spam brushes and stuff? That one would go out to my friend Keith. okay, so here's our ground. And if you put enough turpentine on the brush and you go along the ground, you're gonna get roots. Isn't that great? Isn't that magical? Did you guys see that? Dip it into turp. Let's bring you in a little more. There, now you're getting up close and personal. Okay. You see it better? So, turp can, dip, dip. Here's my turp here, right? And in the paint, and then I'm gonna push. You need enough turp so that it runs at the bottom. You want it to run because these are roots. We're putting down roots from this tree. And nature's very random, so our roots are gonna be very random right here. Roots. There we go. And you put one there maybe. Yeah, I like it already. Digging it. I'm digging it. Are you guys having fun doing this? This is really fun. Don't be afraid. You can't screw it up, really. So what's under a tree? What holds a tree up? Roots. By the way, without trees, we're in deep trouble because we breathe in what they breathe out, and they breathe in what we breathe out. So trees are critical. All this cutting down the rainforest is ridiculous. It's like the human race is trying to kill itself. People are not thinking like they should be. Scary. Okay, so we're gonna put a bunch of roots. I have not seen this anywhere. I just decided to do this. So under the ground though, I know one thing. All trees have roots. So, isn't that interesting how the paint picks to go down? All right, and I'm just gonna leave it. Did you see how I did that? Are you doing that at home? Isn't that fun? All right, and then you don't want a lot of turp on your brush for the rest of this. Because you'll get roots like that everywhere. I got a root on my palette. Can you see it? It's starting to go, it's getting ready to come after me. Rags, the best rags, the most fabulous, wonderful, thick absorbing rags are old towels. Neighbors, friends, ask everybody that you know. Get some towels. I've got my big, beautiful blue heron in the canal out there. Oh, I'm gonna paint him one day too. Okay, so we cleaned that little almost mess up. You know, the fun thing about these videos is they're not edited, so my cats could get in a fight, or my dog could run in and jump up on me, or, you know, anything that happens, I just let it roll. All right, they can do reality TV. Here's real reality. See, just dropped something. Whoops. Isn't this fun? We're having a ball now. Oh, boy. Here we go. Okay, so I'm going to do a little old tree, and we're going to put it, where do we want it? More toward the top, I think. And this, I'm going to look out my window at, I've got a lot of trees out there. So I'm going to, I'm just going to put a little, little leaning tree, kind of looks almost like an apple tree out there or something. Not sure what it is, but trees look like they like people, you know? They're like little fat little characters with their own personalities. And by the way, I'm just using burnt umber, which is a real dark brown and black right now. And I want to kind of get the personality of the tree here. And then I'm going to do a bunch of broken colors in the background and make this really fun. This is going to be kind of like the tree of life, I think. Like, what is it called? Yggdrasil in the Viking mythos. I love to talk about ancestry and myth and fantasy. And, you know, I'm more into the Strega myself, personally Italian because of my bloodline, and all the stories and remedies and folklore associated to that. But oh, by all means, it's very interesting to learn about the Vikings and the Native Americans and the, you know, voodoo and whatever. It's all fabulous. It's just mysterious, wonderful things that. Ooh, here comes the blue heron. Oh, he flew right by the window. Oh, I wish you guys could have seen that, but he's down there. All right, so we have this old tree. fabulous old tree that just kind of grows. Yggdrasil, the tree of life. Don't they say Odin hung by this tree to gain wisdom, knowledge, or something? I don't know. So if you're doing a tree, here's the cool thing. It's not like a person. You could screw a tree up bad and nobody will know it. You know, unless you put the wrong bark or the wrong leaves or something on the species, then people might know it. But I mean, you know, when you're doing a grouping of trees and you squint and you put leaves together and whatnot, yeah, nobody's gonna know about that. Maybe other people standing there painting with you, like our Saturday group, they might know, but I've been painting with the Michigan Plein Air Painters for, I don't know, I think about 14 years. I was an artist and I took a plein air painting class with Heiner Hertling, my buddy. He's like family to me. And he showed me painting life outside of the studio. Aside from, you know, drawing ladybugs and stuff when I was a little kid in the garden. So when you're doing this tree today, okay, for Earth Day, I think everybody should try this. It's super fun. Even if you just want to use one color, you don't feel like making a mess today. I hold the brush very lightly, okay, and I drag it up, and at the very ends, you're going to lift it kind of off a palette off the canvas. So here's our trunk of our old tree. We need a little rag. Always need rags. Okay. That goes up like that. I love Enigma. If you guys listen to me, you already know this. It's kind of my thing. My jam. So the tree of life, where do we think this whole concept came from? I know there's already a story about it and the branches of the cosmos. It's a cool story. Did you guys see Avatar, that gorgeous tree? Oh, it's fun. Okay, so this branch is gonna come down. Trees also go from thicker to smaller, right? And at the end, they just kind of have little branches. This guy's gonna have some funky stuff because I feel like making a real strange tree here. What kind of tree is this? I don't know. I don't even care. It's a tree I felt like painting. Sometimes branches come in towards you too. So let's put one. A little burnt umber. Am I in the way of the camera? I don't want to be. It's going to be something I'm aware of now. I was watching one of my other films and I went, oops. Oops. So I am looking out my window over there at this tree. It's kind of a gloomy day, but I really want to put color. So I'm going to be putting color in this tree. Is not hard. Do not tell yourself art is hard, by the way, unless you want it to be. Hmm. So we've almost got the skeleton here of this tree. I do have some weepers in my yard, but this is not supposed to be a weeper. Weeping cherry and weeping snow fountain. Oh, they're such fabulous trees. And then what happens is after the beautiful flowers are gone, you have this luscious green bunch of, you know, cascading down. Just very cool branches all summer, and it's a lot of fun. I like it. So yeah, we need different sizes too. You don't want, see, the human brain wants to do trees like a popsicle, stick with a ball, right? You know, when you're a little kid, you do a ball, you do a stick, there's your tree. That's not what trees look like. And the other problem, or a pine tree, you do a triangle. Another problem is people will make the trunk just brown and the top green. Another problem is all the branches will be the same thickness, and that's not accurate either. So like in an old tree like this, probably this bottom branch is a little bigger. So is this one. And then it gets smaller as it goes. There's a branch that fell off right there. And this is almost like that. Yeah, this is fun. I'm having a great time. I hope you're doing this. Who cares if you screw it up? You're making art, you're freeing your brain. You can paint whatever you want. This is your little world here. And I want to have a bunch of colors coming through here, too. I'm going to have a bunch of colors mixed in, so I don't want to overdo that too much. So I didn't have a cool green earthy. My only shirt is the Nature Girl shirt, and I've already worn it in a few videos, so I thought this flowery one would be fun. I'm going to have to get on online and look at their little... get a green shirt to wear. I love green. All the chloroform. Is it chloroform or chlorophyll? I don't know. Okay, so. I'm seeing a dark area here. I don't know what it is, it's just dark. So I'm just gonna put it in like this. We're just going to fill it in dark because it's dark right here. I don't know what it is, really. But remember, paint what you see and you can't go wrong, right? Okay, so let's finish this tree. Get the basic bare bones in here, right? So, oh boy, this is, sometimes you just gotta put the brush down and paint what you see and just do it. Just go for it and be bold. Yeah, I guess worst case scenario, if you really screw it up, it's okay. Oil's a lot more forgiving than watercolor, that's for sure. Okay. Oh, this is a strange looking tree. I've got a lot of strange looking trees out here. One of them I call the lion tree because in the summer when it gets all full of leaves and everything, it looks like a giant mane on a lion. Really, really cool. All right, so. Dreamy Enigma music. If you've never listened to it, give it a try. YouTube even has free Enigma channels, but occasionally you get commercials if you don't subscribe. Now, I grew up in that generation where I don't want to pay for TV or music. I'm dating myself. not afraid to say my age. I'll be 49 next month. I look at that as a privilege. Not everybody has the opportunity. You know, why is aging got to be terrible and awful? And why do we have to fear it? And why do we have to get Botox? And why do we have to worry about wrinkles? I mean, isn't that natural, normal part of life? When did that become villainized? When did it become bad to be old? I mean, elders used to be highly respected. Okay, so we got a little branch here that broke off and died. It's just sitting there. Little stump. I like this tree already. Do you like your tree? If you're not doing one, do you like this tree? If you don't say anything. Just kidding. Oh, holy branches. Wow, this is like trying to paint a frozen octopus. Well, if it doesn't challenge you, it doesn't make you better. It doesn't change you, right? Oh, shoot. This might actually come out a little bit. My bad. Sorry about that. That wasn't quite as broken off as I thought. Feels like my voice gets scratchy when I'm talking. I always had kind of a Stevie Nicks voice. Not a smoker, so I don't know. It's just the voice I was given. Okay, so... And this little tree. Very peculiar. This is a very peculiar looking tree. Now, don't worry if your tree doesn't look like my tree. Nobody will know. Just keep going and have fun with it. The whole time you're painting, I want you to say, I am having fun and I'm awesome. I want you to say that to you. Every morning when you get up, before you do anything else, look in the mirror and think, I am awesome. Whether you are or not, doesn't matter. If you believe it, you're going to have a good day. Okay, so... guy here goes way off to here. Now we're gonna about ready to start the color. That's gonna be fun, and this is not gonna be a finished looking tree. This is gonna be much more of a artsy kind of tree that you might put up above a fireplace, or if you don't have a fireplace, maybe in a, I don't know, kitchen, bathroom. I'm not sure about your style, but usually, too, here's another thing. Trees aren't noodly and wormy and round. They usually have, you know, where they hit a point, there's a little knot or a nub. And they're pretty flat. Look at sticks. They're usually, they're round and tubular, like the trunk and the shape, like this brush. But they're straight in their growth patterns for the most part. There's always exceptions to every rule. So sometimes I don't even like to give rules, but... this old tree has a shitload of personality. This would be like Lucille Ball or something if it was a person. Okay, so I need to get a little more burnt umber, a little more black, mix them. I'm having a great fun time. I still, and I've been saying this for 4 videos, I still have to finish the arm on the goddess in the light. I'm just letting it completely dry and I'm gonna paint over it. Photograph myself, my own arm. Okay. This old tree. Kind of like that, I think. See, it's spring, so there's not, I mean, there's a little bit of buds out on the branches, but there's not a lot of what I would call foliage. So it's a lot harder to paint a tree in the spring, by the way, just in case you haven't tried. A lot harder. It's like painting a maze of different moving things. It's kind of hard. Oof. There. Okay. I want to thank you for your comments, too, and everybody saying, oh, you make it look so easy. You got to remember, too, it's just like any other skill. The longer you do it, the better you're going to get at it. You know, I've been doing art my whole life, and I'll be 49 next month, so do the math of how many minutes I have logged. It's kind of like, you know, what you put the most energy and focus into is what you become. If you spend a lot of hours every day drawing and painting, years and years and years of that, you're going to become a lot better, if nothing else. If you spend a lot of time playing video games, you get good at video games. If you spend a lot of time playing piano, you get good at piano. You spend a lot of time working out and training, you're gonna build that house, you know? So whatever you put your focus and your time and your energy into, you become. It's not luck. It's not, you know, you were given a gift from birth nobody else can have. No. It's persistence. It's having the will to continue. This tree is bigger at the bottom. I didn't quite make it big enough here at the bottom, so we gotta make it a little bigger. I got my hand out like, ah! Sorry. Got an old knot here. If you've ever really looked at trees too, boy, they're pretty tricky. Okay, so I'm still using the same brush. I'm just gonna swooshy swoosh it around. Good to go. Wipe it on my rag. And at the end of the branches, I'm going to take my kind of dry brush and just fuzz them out a little. Why do I do this? Because you don't want your eye going to the ends. Your ends are kind of going to be fuzzy and gone, right? So I just make them, whoops, disappear. Really appreciate all of you that are subscribing on YouTube and liking my videos. Helps me a ton to know how many followers I have and if you guys like things or not. Shoot, I've even got people on Patreon. Send a thank you out to all of them supporting me. Even if it's just, you know, $1 a month or $2 a month, it means you like what I'm doing and you support me. That's huge. It's wonderful. Thank you so much. Just watching this is supporting me. So I think this is a little bit too, this was too round for me. And guess what? You can't see that tree out there, so you don't know. Wee. Ah, sorry. Okay. I did just leave this, didn't I? I never finished this guy. I'm gonna add a little cobalt, just a little cobalt blue in, just because I feel like it. I don't really even have a reason. just kind of gives it a blue tint. This is tricky. You got to practice. So this branch. Okay, maybe it needs a little more dark. That's easy though. Also, you know, after 14 years of plein air painting, I have painted a lot of trees. That doesn't necessarily mean I'm good at it, but I do have practice. Oh, look! Canadian geese are trying to build a nest in our yard again. Oh, boy. Goose poop. Neighbors' kids found a little baby painter turtle in the road in front of my driveway yesterday. Turtles are laying their eggs, and all the little spring critters are, aw, look at them. I love nature. Okay, now, I just did something on purpose that I did not like, and the reason I did it was I'm going to show you how you can erase it. Take a clean brush and a little Terp, wipe it on your rag, and if you want to erase something, you can just do this. See how it picks the paint up? Oil paint's beautiful, lovely stuff. I'm going to get you guys in closer to the painting. You don't need to see me.